Las Vegas, known to many as a city of sin, plays host every year to the largest car show in America. We traveled 2,500 miles through a journey where all odds seem to be against us, in hopes of breaking into an unfamiliar market. Joined by Jonathan Drew, Scott Chester, Carl Krantz, and the rest of the crew, we'll take you behind the scenes of our most difficult times, and what may be our most famous creation.
They blew the transmission.
Still one state away.
Runs out of gas.
The situation is bleak.
They've gotten a flat tire.
He's still at least 6 hours from here.
He gets stopped by the cops last night.
Oh, the car's not even here yet.
They think that he has drugs and large amounts of money.
So we're not in a good shape for making the show.
We are stuck. It's 8:30 in the morning. We were supposed to have the car here. Last chance to get the car in the show, maybe like around 4 or 5 o'clock this morning. That's not gonna happen.
The new morning has come and still no car. So we do the next best thing. Head down to the convention center and see what our last options are.
Yes, I wanna thank everybody for coming this evening for the acid donk experience.
Yeah, the acid donk will be thanking people when they bring it.
Look at that badass thing.
Jonathan Drew and Scott Chester of the Drew Estate Cigar Company, makers of the Acid Cigar, are on their way to meet with Gordon Ting of Rides Magazine in hopes of getting a late registration for the car, which is still in transit from Miami, Florida.
Now, Gordon, you know, you and I spoke, we had everything set up, and I'll tell you what, once the car is done, it's in my possession, I won't be late tonight. Once the car's handed to me from Carl, I don't come late to things. I'm here days early, you know what I'm saying, bro? You gotta say, this is not my industry. I'm just getting into
Scott. Just
sorry for the extra stress. You got a lot on your hands right now. You didn't need it either.
We're good.
I'll be a lot happier if I get you guys situated.
At this point, we're gonna do our best. Our time to con in is expired.
Now knowing that our chances are grim, we meet with Ben Harris of Harris Publications, who has been aboard with us from the beginning. They publish such magazines as Rides, XXL, King, and Donk, and their involvement has been paramount in making the Acid name known in a world where John Scott never imagined they would be in.
Nicely done, but you like the ad?
It's looks
pretty
good.
Fresh, right? Yeah. Ain't it fresh?
Just craziness, man. Craziness. We've been working on the car since... I haven't actually stopped working on the car since last Monday, which is now a week and a day, which is 8 days that I haven't slept. The trip, man, trip was crazy. It was just problems one after the other. Orlando, literally like every time we stopped for gas, it was a new problem, you know. The cops, we did make friends with a couple cops, so even though, you know, we got good feedback for the car, we had a lot of people beeping, a lot of people trying to stop, take pictures with the car, but it was just crazy, crazy, craziness.
Put this in the truck. This is the easy part. We're in Vegas already. Detail the car. Peter's gonna help us. Gonna wax on, wax off.
Nice, come on,
get it done. To get a car prepared for a car show photo shoot, the first process is wash the car, then a small buffing can make the car as smooth as possible, as glossy as possible. There's a lot of products involved to detailing a car, from tire shine to vinyl shine. My biggest subject is windows. Gotta be spot clean, no fingerprints. You wash the car again, toothbrush, you get the little minor cracks where you can't really wash it. I personally use a lubricant to get the cracks in places that the compound got stuck. It removes the compound from the hard to reach places. Then you go ahead and give the car a nice hand glaze, and then you're ready for your photo shoot.
The car is so spectacular in the sunlight because of the depth of the candy and the layers of paint and the fading, the airbrush work that give it the richness that mimics the sky and the outside of Miami on a beautiful afternoon. I love the tropics, you know, I think people love the tropics. So I wanted to bring that sunshine everywhere the car went. I think the people appreciate that, and there'll be more, and there are other human experiences that I like to paint that people can relate to. It has to look like a painting, it has to feel like a painting, and the car looks and feels like a painting, that's for sure.
Here we are at SEMA, getting ready to do some damage.
What is SEMA? Quite frankly, SEMA is the premier automotive specialty products trade show in the entire world. It's showcased with crazy art, loud cars, and of course, beautiful women. SEMA attracts more than 100,000 industry leaders from all parts of the world, and it's not too difficult to see why. With 2 million square feet of the world's most innovative concepts and automotive parts, many domestic and international buyers flock every year to Las Vegas to get a piece of the action. And no matter what your taste, or age for that matter, there's always a little something for everyone at SEMA.
Here for the cannonball run. We're gonna build them a Donk to race. Let's go to rides. The cannonball run is a race with luxury cars. The race begins on the west coast of the United States to Las Vegas. In Las Vegas, the cars get picked up, cars get transported over to China, and the race ends over there in some part of the world. The Fuel Girls is a band in the UK. They came over to SEMA to interview me because they want to build a Euro Donk to compete in the cannonball run.
After his interview with the Fuel Girls, they decide to head over to our hotel where the 72 Impala or Acid Donk is being held. With so much talk about this car, the good people over at Fuel have proposed an idea of having the girls record a video shoot from within the Acid Donk. Not only is this the best thing to happen since arriving in Vegas 5 days ago, it also gives us a chance to make a name for ourselves in a land far, far away. South Philly, Northside, Oakland, Texas.
They say a record ain't nothing if it's not touching, dripping, draw you in closer, make you wanna listen to it. And if you real ill at making music, the listener feel like he living through it. That's how my n do it. I met Slacks back in like 91 rapping. We went to Millersville to get away from gun clapping. It ain't last, I be in class dreaming about 50,000 fans up in the stands screaming out encore. Yo, I'm headed back to Philly.
Well, it's the final night, and we have one last opportunity to show off this work of art. We decide to head down to the Hard Rock for an after SEMA car show. You can see the crowd beginning to form as the car is being driven in. Long and hard were our travels, but we got to see a lot of interesting things, made quite a few new friends, and we met many people who appreciated what we were out there for. And even through all the countless hours, the mishaps, and the misfortunes, it was nice to see a reminder of who we were and what we had already accomplished. Many thanks to many people, and we hope you enjoyed the time. And make sure you keep an eye out for the Acid Donk.